guys. So we're back at it. It's been a really long winter. Weather's starting to get nice out. Winter is our busy time at work, so I haven't really had a chance, obviously, to get this thing running. I had a couple questions about how to set the timing, so we're gonna go through it today, talk about the ignition system, and hopefully fire it up. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is set our crank. We know that most motors run well between 12 and 16 degrees for your initial timing setting. So we set ours to 14. I always split the difference and start there. We can always fine tune afterward, but it should fire up and run no problem. So once our crank is set up at 14 degrees before top dead center, we're gonna go ahead and make sure that our cap and rotor are facing in the right direction. On our 351, we know that the front cylinder on the passenger side is cylinder number one. So what we wanna do is follow that spark plug wire up to the cap. You can see that it's this post right here. If we remove the cap, you can see I have a gold line right here in the distributor. I transferred the center of the cap, or the center of the post, as with a mark on the outside, and I moved that also to the inside. It's just a real quick visual reminder of where that rotor should be pointing. You can see now that at our 14 degrees before top dead center, the rotor's 180 degrees out. It's pointing away from the mark we need it. So what we're gonna do is loosen the distributor tie down. We're gonna pull the distributor up and rotate this around so that the center of our rotor is in the center of our mark. We know then that the motor will fire up and run no problem. So in a traditional street rod build, it would be common to have a vacuum advance and a mechanical advance with your distributor setup. For us, being that it's supercharged, we don't have any vacuum available to use those options. So we're gonna let the Holley Sniper EFI communicate with the MSD electronically, and that's gonna change our timing curve all the way throughout the power band to give us the optimum power. So since we don't have a mechanical or a vacuum advance in this setup, we need to lock the distributor out. To do that, we pull the rotor off, pull the housing off, and here you would have a weight on this side with a little spring to this post and a weight here with a weight to this post. That's your mechanical advance. Previously, I pulled the collar out the bottom, picked this up, spun it 180 degrees and bolted this back down. Now that's locked out, the Holley Sniper will control the rest. So in our build, we have four main components of the ignition system. We have a distributor, the Sniper EFI, an ignition coil, and our MSD box. We are going to be swapping out the box that we currently have to this 6 EFI box. The EFI box is nice because it's made to work directly with an EFI system just like ours, and it has a smaller RF signal, so it's not going to interfere with the computer, which is located right here under this front cover. The way these work is it's about a 6-wire hookup like any other MSD box. It has nice quick adjustment for the rev limiter right here on the side, and the Holley Sniper, since it's going to be controlling the timing now, it's going to send the signal over to the box. The box will send the signal to the coil on when to fire, which is going to send the spark over to the spark plug through the distributor. All right, guys, so that's the ignition system. Hopefully that takes care of any of the questions you had. If you still have any, post them in the comments below. We got no problem answering them. What's left here? So I'm going to go ahead and spend the rest of the day getting that MSD box swapped out. So there's no point boring you with that. In the next episode, we're going to be going through the fuel system. I mentioned before that we have some modifications to do. I got a sump getting welded in the gas tank, some new fuel lines and routing. So we're going to go through that. And then we're one step closer to firing it up. So make sure you hit those subscribe button, the notification button. You're not going to want to miss it. It shouldn't be long before we get this thing running.